Good evening. I'm Raymond Foster, and I'm doing a progress report for Harry's Icebox Cleaning website. I'm doing this project by myself, so every objective that I do is, well, I did all the objectives. I felt it was the best this way, and let's actually get into the report. So I first had to design an attractive homepage, messaging logos, a favicon, etc. So I chose this seafoam green with another highlight of green up here. At the very top, I says, please look at our reviews on Yelp. You can actually click on that link and actually go to a Yelp page. I kept it a home catalog and about us. And I actually have blog posts as well. They're just actually not live and hidden. I'll actually get into that later. One of the things I did notice, though, about actually trying to use such things as Uber or Postmates is that it's no longer available or can't actually be used with, and well, actually, in fact, they've actually closed and stopped those programs. So I can no longer use a Uber-like service to actually utilize the, the actual shipping. So I said, just for the purpose of this assignment, you know, that we would actually do the shipping as opposed to using an Uber Rush or Postmates, that's what it used to be called. Funny enough, Shopify used to actually have this integrated into their site. You could just enable it and it would just work. So then I came down, I added a video at the top, showed a picture of a clean refrigerator versus a dirty dirty refrigerator. And I also kind of kept it simplified when it came to the products. I kept the cleaning products here, starter bundle, super bundle, and the ultimate bundle. Inside of those, it's also explained as well. Very clean, small site. I know when I go to websites, I don't want clutter. I want things to look rather neat. That's just how I actually go about looking at a website. So for this, I went simple. Didn't want to go cluttered on purpose. Next is using Google Tag Manager, install of various codes, tracking codes, and making sure that we can monitor and measure all KPIs and etc. So that's another issue with Shopify. Shopify doesn't actually have, they don't actually utilize Google Tag Manager integrated. You would need to install it yourself, but that's a feature that you would have to pay for. So instead of actually using that particular KPI for Google Tag Manager, I actually have went and I've closed it out already on accident. I actually went and installed all-in-one dashboard. And this does all the analytics for me. Honestly, if I was using actual Shopify for a real site, I would probably use something like this, given that it would just be easily manageable. It has the revenue, orders, average order value, customer structure, that whole thing, the processing times, the best-selling products. These would automatically aggregate the analytics that I'm actually looking for. So for that, I would honestly prefer it. Like I said, some of the technical issues as to why I couldn't actually download the manager was this piece of code at the top right here where it says head. You can actually install that, but where you need to install the body, Shopify doesn't give you access to because it's a security issue and you need to actually pay more money to install it. I don't know if that's an actual issue, an actual security issue, but that's the reason stated, at least online. So assume that this product is only sold in San Diego County. Well, it's just a county. I'll fix it in a second. So here I have the actual website, and then the About Us section. It will tell us about, hello, we're in San Diego. I made a mock-up history and kind of told a little bit about iceboxes and refrigerators as a whole, and then talked about cleaning and how we actually got into the cleaning business. And just you know, just made a decent background story just for some people to actually know that we are a San Diego business. I even threw in there that we operate in Pacific Beach. So that works as well, especially for the people in Pacific Beach. And add additional pages and forms, blogs, posts to help support the sale of this product. At least 3 blog posts must be created. So the About Us page was supposed to actually be a blog post, but I felt as it could have its own special page. And then 2 other blog posts, I will actually pull those up right now. Let's go to the blog post. Let's go home. I did a picture history of refrigerators. Let's actually view this post live. I did a picture history of refrigerators. Felt there was a different break and something nice to break it up. I already did the 500 post requirement. I'm not sure if I needed to actually do all 3, so I just did 2 of them. I probably should have asked that before, but at this point it's too late, so. On. But this one is actually still hidden. I have to unhide it. This is what I call clean your refrigerator. I actually put some reasons as to here why you should actually clean your refrigerator. Some of the points that was touched on, you know, just actual food and mold and complications that you can have from these different things. You know, they can cause cancer, it's poisonous. And as also, well, you know, we all know it's food poisoning. And then I actually gave some of the complications of food poisoning just in case people were thinking, well, how does this apply to me? I don't really need to worry about it. I'm good. So I've also included that as well. And that concludes the video. Thanks for listening. I know this is running over the 5-minute limit. It wasn't difficult to put the video, the project together, but it would have been helpful had we could actually, I guess, come together as a class. Thank you for listening, though.